Thanks for checking out the video. I've been Definition, you've been the best, and I'll see you next time. Wait, we've started in the future again. Sorry. Welcome to the Heavy Spoilers Show. I'm your host, Definition, and this video, we're breaking down Neil's timeline in Tenet. He has one of the most confusing out of all of the characters in the film, so throughout this, we're going to be going through it step by step and discussing how the events play out from his point of view. There will be heavy spoilers here, so if you haven't seen the movie yet and don't want anything ruined, then I highly recommend that you turn off now. If you're still here, huge thank you for clicking this. Now let's get into Neil's timeline. Okay, so since my first Tenet video, I've been getting a lot of requests to do a full timeline breakdown for all of the characters in the film. I've actually already made one for Kat, and I'll leave that video linked above if you want to check it out. Now, you might not realise, but she and Sator go on pretty much the exact same journey throughout the film as far as inversions are concerned, so if you want to see what happens to her and the antagonist, then yeah, that's the video for you. Mirroring this, Neil and the protagonist go on very similar journeys, and for the most part, bar a couple of scenes, they're on the same path. Now, before starting the timeline that we see in the film, I want to talk about one of the major fan theories floating around about the character. That is, that Neil is actually the adult version of Max, aka Kat's son. If you don't subscribe to this way of thinking, that's fine, but I think it gives us a good point to start the character's timeline off at, and we will still be giving a proper jumping off point as far as things in the movie are concerned. So yeah, jump ahead if you don't care. But if you do, the first time that we see Max chronologically is on the boat during Kat and Sator's vacation. Kat catches a woman diving over the edge of her husband's yacht, and because of this, it sets the character off on a path that would lead to her future version killing him minutes before the events in this scene. Max, apparently unaware of everything that's going on, then carries on like normal. I say unaware, but look at the boy's face when Kat dives off the boat. Anyway, Max is taken to school, where his mother visits him for the brief few moments at the end of the day, in between it finishing and the boy being picked up by his father's men. I'll move this point to the start now, as things for the character still continue to travel on chronologically. The events of the movie split not too long after this, with the protagonist and his mother travelling back in time. Max continues forward until the end of the movie, which is when he's picked up by his mother at school, and he actually gets to go home with her due to his father's death. Now, if the theory is true, then after the protagonist ties up the last loose end in Priya, he joins the pair and becomes part of their life. This is the start of the beautiful friendship that Neil was referring to, and he grows with him. Tenet agents throughout the film keep themselves to themselves, even refusing to have chit-chat in case they learn anything about each other, so the fact that Neil knows the protagonist's favourite drink does hint to them being close. That's just one of the many things that support this theory, and I don't want to belabour the point too much as I've already done a full video covering it. Max then grows up and gets a master's in physics. He learns about his father, and also how the protagonist saved not only his mother's life, but the world itself. He and the protagonist form a friendship, and through him, he's recruited and trained. With Sator being his father, it's likely that he was raised bilingual, and this explains how he can speak Estonian. Because of this, he realises that he will be the perfect person to go back and help in the mission, and thus decides to return the favour in saving the protagonist's life. As for his identity, he knows that if he tells the protagonist that his name is Max, then he will figure out who he truly is, so he takes the last four letters of his name, does a Tenet on them, and then calls himself Neil. Neil then inverts and travels back in time. Again, this is all just a theory, and you can totally roll your eyes at it. I just thought I'd include it as I don't think that this would be a full timeline video without looking at what Neil was potentially doing before the events of the movie. Anyway, if you skip that part of the video and are back with us, our first encounter with Neil happens at the opera house. Throughout the movie, we learn during this moment that the events of the finale are also playing out, which includes the battle at Stalisk 12 and Kat's mission to the boat. So, there are actually four versions of Neil existing at this point, and five if you include Max. Try and get your head around that. Anyway, we're just going to be following the one. I'm going to turn the background red, as in Tenet, this is used to show time travelling forward. During this, whilst the protagonist is dumped at a wind turbine, Neil hides in the shadows. The pair then meet, which is the first time for the protagonist, and here they do the mission with Priya, and shortly after decide to carry out the siege on the airport. This is pretty much a central location for the film, and one that we will be travelling to again in just a bit. The movie continues to play out in chronological order, with us then arriving at our next point, which is the car chase. This goes to hell, and Kat is shot with an inverted bullet not long after. The protagonist decides that he has to invert in order to save her, and Neil joins them. They realize that there's an inversion turnstile at the airport, and thus they'll be able to revert back to normal when the initial siege is going on. I'm going to turn this part of the diagram blue, as that's the color that's used in the movie to show when time's inverted, and it just clears things up a bit. Now with the protagonist and Kat, they then go back to the airport, which is when the fight happens between the protagonist and himself. Neil manages to revert Kat back to normal, and in secret, the trio travel alongside their past selves, figuring out what to do next. They realize that Sator will have gone back to his time on the boat, as this is when he was at his happiest. The group then once more invert and go back to the day of this, with Neil remaining in inverted time whilst the protagonist switches back to normal. However, during the mission, he sees one of Sator's men setting up a booby trap at the entrance of the tunnel. Left with little option, Neil decides to invert once more, and thus he travels back into the red zone. Though he fails in warning them about the trap, he does still come in useful as he pulls them out of the cabin before it collapses in on itself. It's here that Ives, the protagonist, and Neil have their farewell and decide to split the pieces of the algorithm up. Neil actually gives the protagonist his piece of the algorithm as he realizes that he's the only person who can unlock the door for the protagonist in the bunker. He explains exactly what's been going on and how the pair were actually friends. Pattinson delivers one hell of a performance, and when he says, "I'll see you at the beginning, friend," I still get goosebumps. I'm not crying, you're crying. Now, for him, this is the last time that the pair will actually talk with one another, and it ends what he sees as a beautiful friendship. Neil then inverts once more and travels to the bunker, where he unlocks the door for the protagonist before diving in front of a bullet in order to save the character's life. At this point, there are actually four versions of the character that we know for definite, spread across the timeline, moving backwards and forwards in order to get to this one final moment. Across all four, Neil is doing whatever he can to save the protagonist's life, and it shows just how much he values the friendship that they had. Now, whatever way you look at it, whether it be the Max theory or not, from this point on, the protagonist then travels back to the events of the car chase with Sator, tying up all the loose ends that were left behind. You may not agree with us, but if we're right in our speculation, then the protagonist then joins the pair, and we go back to the start of our timeline in which we followed Max growing up. This ends the movie, and also our time with the character, creating a perfect loop in which he and his friend saved the world. And that's the video. Now obviously, I'd love to hear your thoughts on it, and the film itself, so make sure you comment below and let me know. This video gave me a migraine making it, so if you appreciated it, then I appreciate you dropping a thumbs up, as it massively helps us out. I also want to give a huge shout out to Cook Pete on Twitter for putting together a massive timeline of the movie, and I actually came across it when trying to put this video together, and it really helped me fine-tune the events. So you're the true Neil of this video. Now, if you want to watch something else Tenet-based, then make sure you check out our full breakdown of the theory of why Neil is Kat's son after this. If the first part of the video had you rolling your eyes a bit, then definitely check that out, as we've compiled all of the evidence that supports the theory. Don't forget, we're also giving away a free copy of the Christopher Nolan collection, and all you have to do to be in with a chance of winning is like the video, subscribe to the channel, and drop a comment below. The winner is going to be chosen at random on the 30th of September, so make sure you get involved. If you want to support the channel and get to see content early, then please consider clicking the join button below. You can also come chat to us on our Discord server, linked in the description, or Heavy Spoilers on Twitter. Thanks for making it until the end of the video. You've been the best. I've been Definition. I'll see you next time. Take care. Peace. And finally can end the video. I'll see you at the beginning. Cheers.